Hey YouTube, I'm Sergeant Indy and this is Xcom 2, heading into Operation Stormwalk to recover an item from an advent facility. Now, this is a guerrilla op to keep the retaliation timer from going forward 2 weeks, which I don't really care about, but we're going to get an engineer out of it, which I do care about. I've got Liang in the war suit, which just completed, and I'm not sure if that's the best decision or not, but it gives her 2 armor with her little built-in perk that she got from the AWC. Also got Weber with the Skulljack. We'll probably try to use that this mission. This is post-commentary. I guess my house was just crazy loud for several videos. Not much I can do about that now, except for try to re-record it.
Menace, ready to deploy.
One of our resistance contacts tipped us to an advent patrol group storing a secure data vault in this area, and it looks like the files are critical to the aliens' latest operation. We can't pass up any opportunity to stop their progress, so we're moving to capture those assets. Neutralize any hostile contacts nearby and secure the area.
Okay, kill the bad guys and recover a thingy. I was also kind of hoping that a recover thingy usually means hacking something, and I was hoping I'd get a hacking bonus. Spoiler alert, I don't. I don't ever get one, so all my hackers end up being kind of useless, which sucks, but, well, what are you gonna do?
Menace 1-5, we've got a bead on the Advent Data Vault near your position. Be advised, self-detonating charges are in place at the target. Move to disarm and extract the package before its contents are destroyed.
Okay, we got concealment. Pretty sure I put Liang on point first. That way if she gets accidentally revealed, we've still got Schaefer kind of in reserve with his phantom ability.
Headed there now.
Got a decent amount of ground to cover and 8 rounds to do it in, so we need to keep a decent pace to get through this in one piece without failing the mission. You don't want to fail these missions. There was some nasty consequence to them. And this one, the retaliation mission timer goes up. In some of the other ones, you can actually lose one of the country bonuses, like lose contact with them and have to remake contact. That's a real pain in the butt. I don't think that ever happened to me on this playthrough, but it's something I discovered in my last playthrough in one of the lost videos. I was just trying to skip a mission to go straight to, like, gosh, at that point my retaliation timer was like 5 days or something. And I was just trying to make contact as quickly as possible and ended up losing a continent because of it. Not a continent, a country. Stun Lancer, Advanced Trooper, and one of those Mutant Centurions. So that whole pack is just going to be a huge pain in the butt. Liang is packing a rocket launcher on the war suit because I haven't researched any of the new heavy weapon things for it yet, but rocket launcher itself is actually kind of cool. I mean, having a free rocket on your assault is pretty nice. There are better heavy weapons for it, but and I'll take it. Like I said, having Liang have 2 points of armor is pretty solid at this point in the game. I've got to make a move on those guys, and I'm considering, oh, I actually do put Halverson up top, which I guess is my way of saying I guess I don't need him for this pack. Every time I go up to these overpasses, I'm scared that there's going to be a civilian, like, right on it, because for whatever reason they really like to hang out by ladders in the first build of the game. I'm not the only one who's noticed it though, and it's something they sort of fiddled with and fixed now that, like, the first big patch has come out about 3 days ago or so. Yeah.
Okay.
I think I do want to get Weber all the way up to that overpass post, whatever that is, the leg of the overpass, She's a pretty darn good shot, so having her in a good position for Overwatchy stuff is a good idea.
Location confirmed.
There's a specialist class upgrade at the Guerrilla Tactics School that gives... Oh, and there's a second pack. Another stun lancer, another advanced trooper, and an officer.
An admin captain nearby would make an ideal target for the Skulljack.
And I think I do want to try to Skulljack that guy if I can. Just trying to put Schaefer somewhere out of the way so I can keep him in concealment, maybe. Yeah, Wilson doesn't even have line of fire from there, so... Like, I really need to pounce on this target, but I guess I really can't, because it will... It reveal Kelly, and I don't want to deal with both of these packs at the same time. Knock out a scanning protocol with Wilson. This is really useful, and I should have made better use of Wilson. Just so I could have scanning protocol. I mean, like, look how far that range is. That's pretty far. She's pretty far away from those dudes, and she still got them. So I think I am going to have to hold off on ambushing this pack till next round. I've got to pull Kelly back a bit.
Understood. Moving out.
They're not going to make this easy for me. Yeah, I'm pretty much out of luck on this one. Six rounds. Gotta hack the thing. Bright side is I've got two gremlins, so... I mean, pretty much if I could just blow open the side of the thing, I can hack it from just about anywhere I want. It's not that big of a deal. But... Yeah, I do need to move pretty quick. Not nearly as bad as if I had to, like, get somebody all the way there. Like, in base-to-base contact with the thing. Base-to-base contact. I'm talking about... Talking about it like it's a miniatures game. Which really... Like, you could play this game as a miniatures game. The rules aren't complicated. The math isn't complicated. Most things are resolved with pretty simple rolls. It would work pretty well as a... Like a miniatures game. I think I do just... Because, like, I can't even move Kelly, so I'm pretty much stuck taking these guys out, like, here. And that's... That is not good.
Orders confirmed on the move.
Wilson's a pretty good, darn good shot, too, so I tuck her in here, or she'll have a good line of fire on it. Once they split and break. And I'm thinking about throwing a mimic beacon, because I know I will have to deal with the two packs at the same time, and I don't think I quite have the firepower to take both of them out. Move Schaefer up. And he's on Overwatch, but he's got Phantom, so he won't shoot. Which I'm not sure if I had planned on him shooting or not. I frequently do that. I frequently think, oh, well, he's on Overwatch, so I'll get a shot out of him, and I won't get it because it's concealed. Open with a chain shot on the Centurion. I really want him dead. Their aim is ridiculous. So if I shred him twice and get two big fat cannon shots on him, chances are he's going to go down in this ensuing melee. Oh, unfortunately, did I go for a chain shot? Do they get the split before I get my second shot? Could have sworn I went for a chain shot. Yeah, she can take multiple Overwatch shots, so she is a machine right now. Yeah, she just murdered that Stun Lancer. And the Centurion. Like, we probably wouldn't have gotten the Stun Lancer without her. I'm gonna toss the Mimic Beacon with Wilson. Again, I throw it out of cover because I didn't realize that you could throw it in cover and they'll shoot it anyway. It seemed like a ridiculous rule. Why would anybody do that? And they've changed it, so now they'll shoot at the Mimic Beacon regardless, but it doesn't get a cover bonus. Which is fine by me. It soaks up like two hits anyway, and I feel that is worth not bringing a grenade for. Although, actually, you could bring a grenade and a Mimic Beacon, which I think I actually did with Wilson this time. And I think that's another change that I would make to it. I'd make it count as a grenade, so you're giving up cover destruction in order to... And look, the movie begins dead, and that Stunlands are still behaving super irrationally. I wonder if they plan their turn in one go, and then I'll move, because... I don't know, it seems really dumb for that Stunlands to be standing out of cover after the... Like, if he ran up to the Mimic Beacon, I'd get it. But, it seems really dumb what he's doing right now. Nice shot from Halverson. Bad ragdoll. Seriously. Why? That's not smart. Why are they making the ragdoll make that much damn noise? I mean, this isn't a game where physics is super important. I don't know why they freaked out about ragdolls in the first place, but... Like, that'll make noise when they hit the ground, like, one time, to avoid. Well, what just happened, really? Thinking about whacking one of these guys with the Liang sword. I think I've just picked up the thing where if she kills somebody, she is, Oh my god, I actually hit a chain shot. That's amazing. I have terrible luck with chain shots. Specifically with chain shots with Kelly. Yeah, so Stunlancer's down. He's a pretty big threat. The next biggest threat is the Trooper. The officer's kind of a pain in the butt, but the Trooper can just throw a grenade, blow us out of cover, and that really increases the likelihood that somebody gets pretty seriously hurt. We don't want that.
Look out!
Looks like I'm just getting Weber into position for next round. Kind of a bummer. Schaefer is still concealed, so I think I try to move him up somewhere to get a good line of fire for later. And of course, if he does get seen, I can reconceal with Schaefer. But we're kind of... And actually, now that I'm thinking about it, I should have gotten Schaefer out of concealment there. I should have forced him out of concealment to try to kill one of these dudes in order to... Well, in order to try to score a kill. Because I could have reconcealed him, and we're at 5 rounds anyway. There's not much more sneaking around I really could try to pull off.
I can handle that!
Yeah, that 2 armor points really helped Liang out. I mean, she only took like 3 points of damage from a hit. That's amazing. Nice shot, Liang.
You know that was good.
I don't really know what I'm trying to do with Wilson here. I think I'm just trying to get her up. I probably put her into Overwatch because I think the officer's going to bolt. Oh, I flashbang him. Well, that's just as good. That'll... I think that drops his aim by like 20 or 30, and it also drops his movement range, which should keep him from, doing anything too kooky. He also probably can't do that mark thing that he normally does. You lose access to a lot of abilities when you're, My gosh! Yeah, the armor just officially saved Liang's life. 2 hit points left. She's been hit twice. That was a good call. We're getting to the part of the game where I get a lot of critical hits on Liang for like no reason. Like dudes are in cover and that's why we're screwing around on this officer so much, because I want to skulljack him. Not sure if I do or not, but I'm certainly thinking about it. Looks like I don't. Or maybe I do, and I'm just counting on the skulljacking has like a 70% accuracy for some crazy reason. I don't know. It's a high risk maneuver, and you have to do it to make the story proceed. You'd think you'd make it 100%. Yeah, we go for the skulljack. Boom.
We have complete access.
Yeah,
to
crappy hacking skill.
Dedicated our systems to process
and bad RNG.
But we will need to work fast. It is only a matter of time before they detect our intrusion.
Das könnte es sein.
You say we need to act fast, but I mean the hack took less time than him talking about the hack. So yeah, when you hack, You have to fight a codex, and that's a new bad guy. They're a pain in the butt. Every time you do damage to them, they split in two. And then you gotta deal with two of them. They've also got some pretty powerful psionic abilities.
We'll have to neutralize it if we intend to recover the data. Understood.
I think you guys just heard my big fat cat jumping up on my desk. Blow it up. That's a good chunk of its health. Not enough, though. I think I had forgotten that they split. So I was just planning on blowing her cover up and killing her that way.
The Codex is projecting multiple copies of itself into our dimension.
Now, the bright side is when they split, I think they have their health, which makes them a lot easier to manage. Oh.
Still moving.
Bummer. Yeah, it's only got one hit point, so it can't... And this actually worked to our favor. It's only got one hit point left, so it can't actually, Can't split. It can only teleport. Which, it still teleports. It's a huge pain in the butt. It's hard to really plan an offensive against the things if you can't tell where they're gonna be. Shaver picks up that kill, and I'm not even sure if 87%, it's a pretty good chance. I think we finish it off here. That's that.
Happy now?
So yeah, you really don't want to give a codex a turn if you don't.
Some physical remnant of the codex,
like, if you can avoid it.
It,
they've got this... Oh god, Tygon, shut up. He's not even saying anything important. He's just saying, we killed a codex, bring his stupid head back. Okay, that's our hack target.
We have positive confirmation of the target package. Move to acquire.
I really need to heal Yang. I think hopefully I do that now. Looks like I check out the hack first. I hope I go for that. So knowing my luck, she'd still fail it, but lucky she did not fail it.
Nichts ist sicher.
Okay, so I got something way over there. What is it? Oh, I don't even think... Oh, there we go. It was down south further and I missed it. I think it's a snake. I don't think I actually have control of it yet. I think I gain control of it next round. Kind of how similar to how mind control works. Really gotta heal the Yang. What am I doing? She's really hurt. She can't take another hit. And she's gonna be up front to take hits because she's Liang. That's where I put her. That's where she works best. Okay, that's the wall open. Weber should be able to get line of sight for a hack really easy right now. Or Wilson, you know, whatever works. If you hear a notebook rustling around, that's because I just coughed. Damn it, I just dropped a pen, too. I just coughed, and I'm trying to, like, mark down that I coughed. So I can edit it out later. This is my second post-commentary ever. I do not have a good workflow for it. Go good. Yeah, we heal the Yang. Do I have nano med kits yet? No, I do not have fancy med kits yet. Well, that sucks. I still don't think so. Because if I did, I got some really crap rolls. Oh, wow. It revealed right away, too. That's a bummer. That sucks. That sucks, too. Go on, Halverson. Get it together. Those guys way over there. Way over there. The right side is that they're way over there, so I don't really have to deal with them right now. Yeah, right there I should have line of sight to get this hack. I think I might trigger another pack too. Nope, that's good news. Okay. They don't actually try for that, do I? What am I thinking? There's no way she was going to get that. I should have just gotten the small one. I don't really need alien alloys anyway. I've got a load of them. Like, I'm never in danger of really running out. Illyrium? That's another story.
Charges are inactive and the package is secure. Eliminate any remaining hostiles near the AO.
Yeah, they're just too far away for him to have a decent shot. Squad site penalties really rack up in XCOM 2. It's really not quite as, it's not as useful as it was in XCOM 1, that's for sure. Or XCOM 2012. Everybody had squad site in XCOM 1. That was pretty much how you played the game, was wandering around trying to, you know, you'd have like one guy with pretty good accuracy and a halfway decent weapon, and you'd kind of leave him pretty close to the Sky Ranger, and you'd be walking around with other people on point, so you could exhaust all their moves, see a bad guy, and then the guy back with halfway decent accuracy, you could still shoot him and kill him. That wasn't a smart place to move her, but I don't really... They're far enough back, I don't think it's really going to matter. Now, these Vipers are terribly inaccurate. Like, 50% shot. I should have gone for the poison, actually. Because poison really... I mean, the Viper would be immune to it, but the, I'm not sure if the Archon would. It's mostly metal, apparently. I think I go up there trying to wrap it up. Yeah, I can't do it, so. Oh well. Do I poison him? Yeah, still a 50% chance to hit, even, like, point blank. They're not very good shots. Yeah. What are you gonna do? Pretty sure I leave everybody else on over. Yeah, I leave everyone else on Overwatch, hoping that they'll just kind of kill her, and then move up, or I can get shots at him. That doesn't happen though, because she ends up being pretty tough, if I recall. Here we go, Halverson. Nope.
That's not good.
Yeah, they're just too far enough, too far away for him to have a decent shot. But we have no time limit at this point, so we can afford to take our time, set a big Overwatch trap, and we might as well, really. Can't figure out why he can't actually shoot at anybody.
Let's rock!
But I take the reload, and I move him up some. I mean, just a few tiles makes a huge difference. With how, like, squad site. Oh, no, I don't move them up. What am I doing? What am I thinking? I might as well have. They're probably not coming close anytime soon. And his Overwatch shot percentages have got to be like 30% at this range. It's ridiculous.
Already there.
Move Wilson up a bit. I definitely want to keep Weber on Overwatch since she can take multiple Overwatch shots. Yeah, the damage is underwhelming too. That looks like a really nasty rifle. I don't know why it doesn't do more damage. When I'm on a commander, you think it'd be pretty close to whatever the maximum amount of damage would be. Alright. Yeah, I should have moved him up. He's not gonna hit anything from there. It's just not gonna happen.
That is not good.
Mehr hast du nicht drauf?
Okay. I think this is the last pack of aliens, too, so I'm just gonna mop this up and go home. Put him in concealment trying to get... I don't even know really what I was trying to do here. I mean, at this rate, I might as well just keep Schaefer out of concealment so he could fight. But I'm screwing around, kind of... What? Oh, the Archon spotted him. He's right there. Yeah. So I was trying to get a beat on the Archon, and then I did. And it blew my concealment.
I'm on it.
I haven't used Viang's running gun, like, at all. I think it's mainly because since she got so chewed up, I was kind of afraid of, like, losing her. So I'm playing too conservatively with her. Yeah, and here I am, I'm thinking, I have to throw the Mimic Beacon like where he can see it and get to it, or he'll just ignore it. That's not even really the case either. I've got a mission later on where I throw a Mimic Beacon and it's nowhere near guys. It's... That was a fun mission. It's kind of hard to explain that. My squad was really spread out. We had like four packs at once. And I throw a Mimic Beacon and guys run from like all the way across the map to get at it. Like they're running past my troops to get at it. It was crazy. So, I don't know. I was freaking... I was assuming the bad guys were coded relatively intelligently with the Mimic Beacon, and they're just not. They're really dumb. Really, really, really dumb. I don't know why it showed me that burning car, but it did. He takes a shot at it, which is good. His melee accuracy isn't great. His ranged accuracy is even worse. The main reason those guys are scary is because they got a load of hit points and a decent dodge.
Hardly did anything.
Decent amount of damage to the Viper. Wang misses. Yeah, her Overwatch isn't very good. But I can finish that snake off with just about whoever. Like, look at that snake. That snake went all the way across the map to not even get a shot at a Mimic Beacon, just to move aggressively towards it. They're really dumb. Good shot, Weber. Really good shot. She needs a reload.
Come get some.
In hindsight, I really should have used his kill zone ability somewhere too. I just didn't make very good use of it. Yeah. This whole mission's me looking at stuff thinking I didn't make very good use of it. Ooh, very nice shot, Kelly. I was mainly doing that for the holo targeting. So I figure, if I hit a 65, great. If I don't, got holo targeting. And that's good enough. Yeah, might as well just take the shotgun. 100%. Alien down. I don't particularly like Implacable. I mean, I don't know. I'm not using it right. But it's like when you get it, it's a huge game changer for like how you can and should move your dudes. And it's just kind of hard to use. Goes into Overwatch. Now, Schaefer has Shadow Step. I think they both do. Schaefer and Liang both do. That's mostly because, wait, do I need it? Is Halverson gonna? No. Okay. Yeah, Shadow Step, which lets him move without worrying about Overwatch. I don't remember what the alternative to that is. I just know that I was not at all impressed by it, so. Pretty much just take Shadow Step. Get Liang up a bit. We're really spread out. I mean, the only guy who can even really make an actionable... The only guy who can really move on that snake right now is Schaefer. And Schaefer is just not in good enough range to really do anything about it. And I'm free to move her here even though the snake's on Overwatch because the line of sight is blocked within Overwatch range.
Scanning beat.
Big fat cat just jumped up on the desk. You guys probably heard that. Not that fat. He's actually really healthy. He's just super stocky. Why am I stressing out? I've got combat protocol. This is like exactly what combat protocol is for. Well, this and robots, obviously, but I got a guy who's got like 3 hit points and I want him dead. Zap him. Easy.
Mission accomplished.
Okay. Man got pretty heavily wounded. That sucks. But, what are you gonna do? Putting her in that armor, like, seriously saved her life, though. That's good. I don't know what this screen's even supposed to be. I feel like it should be showing something, and it just sucks. So, I don't know. Haven't played it since the patch. The patch might have fixed that.
I can't imagine the aliens are too happy about this one, Commander.
Wang is out for a while. No promotions, that sucks too, but what are you gonna do?
Commander, please thank our troops for completing what was surely a difficult task in acquiring the Codex brain. We'll begin work on it as soon as possible.
Codex brain. Codex leads to only the small, nearly featureless brain when it expires, which is proven remarkably resistant to biological or mechanical scans of any kind. Nothing else really new or exciting.
You have done an outstanding job leading the resistance, Commander.
And we dropped the avatar meter by 1 by killing a codex. That's cool. Just this once. Codexes show up as like regular bad guys later, and you don't get it every time, that's for sure. Now I'm debating what I'm going to do with that engineer. Okay, so I drop her into the communications room so we can go try to make contact somewhere else. Oh no, I don't. I was gonna say, I think it's a while. I'm really keen on finishing off America so that I can get that really cool bonus which finishes all the ammo and grenade projects instantly. Really neat. But I've got more stuff to clear. I think it's quite a while before I actually finish that continent bonus. Okay. Yeah, I got 2 gremlins in the workshop providing power. Gremlin working the med bay. Kind of a bummer that there aren't really, like, if you put people in there, you can see them working around, I think. I want to see the little gremlins buzzing around doing stuff. Okay, so I put the gremlin in the Psy Lab so that I can help Dominga clear this place out faster. That's probably a pretty smart move.
I commend your troops for their resilience in defeating this creature, Commander. The aliens will be left scrambling to recover from this setback.
Okay, more intel. It's interesting. Might as well grab it, I guess.
Avenger plotting new course.
Yeah. At this point in the game, the avatar meter is pretty much a joke. It's not really that big a deal. I don't know. Okay, alloy padding so they get more armor. That kind of sucks, actually. But I got my engineer and that's what I wanted. Alright. Concussive grenade. Oh, I don't even read this stuff. Oh well. It's not that important. It's just an explosion. The explode's good. Advanced explosives will upgrade all of my other grenades. So, like acid grenades, fire grenades, whatever. It'll make them do more damage too. Which is neat, because it's pretty much the only thing that keeps them on par with the plasma grenade, which is super powerful. Really should build that advanced Psyamp. I really should. What am I doing? Oh, I was here looking for the, I was hoping the grenade project would be there. Of course it's not. It's in the damn proving ground like everything else. Spider suit. Really should build one of these for our snipers. I don't know when I get around to it. And I pick up the advanced explosives project now, I think, which probably isn't very smart. Wang's out for 4 days. Yeah, plasma grenades do 5 to 6 damage rather than 3 to 4. Much stronger. They also blow up more cover, like those stupid trees that I couldn't seem to blow up before. They just leave behind a big old stump that's still high cover. They blow those stupid things right out of the ground. Please tell me I get started on the spider suit. Oh, good, because that's important.
As soon as we're finished, Commander.
That's important. Experimental ammo, an experimental grenade, spider suit. Hopefully, ammo, spider suit. Okay, ammo first, then spider suit. That's probably a good idea. Some of the experimental ammo types are really good. Okay, Harris has been trained up. That's good news. Kelly's been trained up. That's good news. And it turns their hair white by default.
Could be considered the aliens' greatest strength. Now our own Psy operatives can tap into that same power.
I don't know. We'll get Witcher training or something. Domination is mind control. That's really cool. Soulfire is guaranteed damage, which is nice. It's not very much damage, but your psyops can't shoot for crap. So Soulfire is pretty handy. Void Rift is stupendously powerful. It's just ridiculous. Because it hits them once with big damage, and then any organic enemy in there has a chance to suffer insanity. Well, you get a thing later that makes insanity also do damage. So it's like hitting them for like 6 twice, and there's not really any like dodging it or whatever. Yeah. So insanity can make panic, disorient, mind control. There might be something I'm forgetting. It's pretty handy. Really neat. Cooldown on it's pretty long. Oh, I give her a will PCS because I thought the will would affect her psi chance. It doesn't. It's got nothing to do with it. So, crap, right? I mean, the hell's the point of the will ones? Like, I don't really care. It's not a big deal that we be resistant to their mind control or whatever. They hardly ever do it. And I think I put her back in for domination? Soulfire. I shouldn't go for domination this soon because her psi ability is so okay. Good. I went for Soulfire. Soulfire like automatically hits too, though. I don't even think there's a roll for it, like based on her psi aptitude or whatever. It's a really good thing to get with low ranking psyops. Though the thing is, every time she learns a new ability, her rank goes up. Her abilities go up, right? So you can train her all the way up. Just leave her in that stupid little psionic booth and get her to maximum rank and maximum effectiveness without even having to go out and see any aliens. I don't know how I feel about that. I think that's kind of, I mean, I don't know. Part of what makes having a powerful soldier worth it is like the risk involved, not worth it. Like the offset, the cost of having a powerful soldier is the risk in getting them high ranking. And I could just stuff her in a tube for like 2 months and then she's just powerful. I take her out on missions and risk her and she gets shot up. It's like she doesn't get anything out of it. So I think about making contact with West Asia and India. I don't want to make contact with either of them. I need to so that I can unlock that other facility in case our thing goes up too high. Did I just clear her out? I think it did. What am I going to do with her? Oh, do I actually put her in comms to try to make contact somewhere? Well, I guess I do that now. Huh. I wouldn't have done that. Now I wouldn't have done that. But I'm tainted. I know how the rest of this video series goes. Because I did it. I was there. I seen it. I think we start making contact with West Asia, and I'm not sure if we ever even finish it. Yeah, but I want to be able to counter the Avatar project if it caps back up. It's really not that big a deal. AP rounds, super strong, amazing. They ignore like up to 5 points of armor. There are things with more than 5 points of armor where they don't pierce those at all, I don't think. Anything with 5 points of armor or less, they just ignore entirely. It's great. Okay, so she's got Soulfire. And I don't know if I put Mercer in here now, or if I just... I don't know what the point of Soulsteel is. When you do damage with Soulfire, you get like half of your hit points back. It's really not that big a deal. Domination's great. Void Rift is amazing. It really is. Okay, yeah. I tuck Mercer into here to get him his initial Psy-Operative training. Okay.
Incoming message for you, Commander. Patching it through to your quarters now.
I had high hopes for the Resistance under your leadership, Commander, and you have outdone yourself.
Alright, there's a Captain Judy Allen and a Dr. Jarn Timmermans available at HQ. I'm pretty sure we go and hire one or both of the Faceless I don't care about. Dropping the supply thing, that's kind of a big deal. I don't have enough intel to reveal a hidden one, which sucks. I really don't treat intel that well here. I look at intel costs as, okay, I need this. I need 80 intel to make contact with India or whatever. And then I just like, okay, let's go get 80 intel. I really should be trying to keep a stockpile of it and treating it like a... It is a valuable resource, and there's a lot of times when I don't have intel and I need it. And... yeah. It ends up kind of screwing me over here and there. I really should treat it as a valuable resource and go after it, and I really don't... I'm really not doing that at this point in the game, and that kind of sucks. I should be smarter than I am. Spider suit has been finished. Awesome, that's great for your snipers to get them to a high place.
Find the results to be as intriguing as...
The aliens aren't going to be happy when they see we've got energy weapons just like theirs now.
She has terrible sight picture. Really bad. Terrible. That's why she's an engineer, not a soldier, I suppose. On more than one occasion during our initial testing of the alien plasma rifles recovered from the field, we nearly suffered a catastrophic loss of the test unit while conducting simple firing runs. After a complete disassembly and analysis, it seems the weapon operates along a very fine threshold between ideal power levels and total system failure. Even the smallest of microfractures to any number of lightly shielded components within the power distribution system could lead to a devastating collapse of field integrity, leaving little chance for the operator's survival. I can only assume at this point that the aliens had little concern for the well-being of their own forces when designing the weapon, as I have no doubt they discovered the flaw during their own testing. In any case, I'll make the appropriate modifications to our internal designs to ensure no such weakness exists for the safety of our own troops. Okay, reaching the endgame now, we've got access to all of the fancy advanced beam weapons, and they're all their own project. It's not like you don't get the beam rifle and the shotgun or the heavy weapon and the whatever. I gotta get it. Maybe we don't need to research them all. So we've got access to the Scram gun, which is the SMG for the Long War, guys. I never build it. In hindsight, I probably should have, especially for someone like Liang. Beam pistol, really good. Plasma rifle, obviously we want those. It's going to take a lot of supplies to pull any of this off. Yeah, okay, they're all their own individual research project now. That's a big pain in the butt. Obviously, oh, and powered armor we've got available too for the final tier of armor. I'm not sure what I go for right now. Looks like I'm thinking about data decryption, which probably isn't smart. I ought to go straight for that storm gun, because getting that thing on Liang is amazing. Same with the plasma lance for the snipers. Beam cannon's a little less of a priority. It's still something you want, but probably the shotgun and the sniper rifle are more important. Okay. Extract a VIP from an advent city. Get a scientist, 88 intel. We want to do this.
Setting course for South Africa.
Thank you. All right. That's what an autofill looks like. It's not bad. We've got plasma grenades now, which is just great. I don't think I want to take Wilson. I think I'd try to take Volkov instead. Oh, no, I remember what mission's coming up next. Take Kelly along. I've got to fiddle with her armor some. Like, she's still in her default tan. Gotta give her a good color for her psi-operatives. Go down here, of course, and I want that plasma rifle, and I want the advanced psi-am, which I think I pick up now. That's kind of more important, because if I sent her out as is, she wouldn't be able to pull anything off. Ooh, we can afford both. Awesome. Awesome. I think I'd just end up screwing around with squad placement for the next couple of minutes. I really shouldn't be messing around with it that much. I do want to take Kelly along, which I think I change her name, because we have Molly Kelly and Dara Kelly. It's like, what, did the aliens devastate Ireland? There's only Kellys left? What's going on? But at any rate, it was confusing, so I'm pretty sure I think I changed her name to O'Brien. Something like that. Another sort of stereotypical Irish name. Definitely given Halvorsen those AP rounds. And man, having a sniper with AP rounds is just super. Alright, next video we're heading into Operation Demon Hound to extract a VIP from an Advent City. Thanks for watching, everybody. I'll see you there.